Oh, we have a Chloe on the bed. Minus her collar. The other three girlies are downstairs running around because the girlies just got done having a bath. They needed their bath. And there's baby Lacey. She had a bath too. She was very cooperative. And so what I'm going to do now is I've got to take all the dog bedding apart. These are the covers that come off, and I just washed their whole bedding. When was it? Was it in September? Early October? It was before I went to my mom's or right after. But I took everything apart, and when I did all the, like, my fall cleaning, I think that's when I did it. So the bedding itself underneath there, the pillow part, doesn't need to be washed, because I just did that. I just need to wash, like, the slip covers of it. And there's our maple. And then maples across the street, you can see they're minus their leaves just about. It's only a little bit hanging on. And my neighbor's plum trees right there has lost just about all of its leaves, and that's what our plums look like too. And there's our elm. Isn't that pretty? And there's more pretty colors back over there by Farmer Tom's. And I need to get out there and cut the grass. The grass doesn't need to be cut, but the leaves need to be mulched up. But they still have our tractor. They had to come get it again over a week ago because even though they were supposed to fix the oil leak, it was still leaking oil. So it's ridiculous. So anyway, I haven't put on my makeup or anything yet today, and I'm sweating because that's a big job to have four dogs. I have to trap them in my bathroom, close the doors, and then I have to lift them one by one into that Roman soaker tub. And when you have 80-pound dogs, that's a big workout. So anyway, I'm gonna cool down while I'm getting my wash ready, and I got towels that I have to take down to the laundry. I just did laundry, what was it, Thursday? But I'm gonna do some whites and towels, so I'll go gather all of those. So I'll have one load of that and one load of doggy bedding, and then I don't think I need this in my hair anymore. What time is it? It's 10:37. So I'm gonna cool down for about 20 minutes while I'm taking the laundry down. Then I'm going to, what am I gonna do? I'm gonna come up here. Oh, I'm gonna put my makeup on. I don't even know if I'm gonna put makeup on. I probably won't, because I gotta get up here and start decorating the whole entire bedroom in the office here, and I got a sleeping kitty. So Harry's got his computer, laptop. I had to move my heater. I keep this in the hallway. It used to be in here, and I never really used it. So I put it in the hallway. That's by that chair that we have there in the corner by where the Christmas tree is. I have the chair and I have that, but it's in here now. And I came over here because I wanted to show you our Japanese poplar tree is bare, and my neighbor's burning bush over there looks really nice. And then all those trees that were in the back over there that were really colorful, all the leaves are off over there. But down the street, it's, I'll have to go outside, but it's still pretty down that way over there. But anyway, so I'm going to get ready to start some laundry. I need a pair of socks first. That really is a workout with those dogs.
The same guy today as he did to start the season. And when running backs get those kind of carries.
Alrighty, so my room is decorated, my tree is done, my garland is still lit. If it happens to go out, because this could be the year it goes out, which I hope it doesn't, but if it does, I have all my backup lights. So I'm just going to give you just a quick look around, because you guys will be seeing my Christmas decorations as I'm doing my vlogs, walking through my house. But then, of course, I'm going to save everything so when I do my house tour. And I usually do my house tour, like, I think right after Thanksgiving. I get through at least Thanksgiving, and after that, then I go ahead and do my house tour. The reason why I wait until after Thanksgiving, because up until about Thanksgiving, that's now all the stores out will have all their Christmas out. And so if there's any like last minute stuff that I see that I want to buy, that I want to add to my home decor, that's what you hear right there. Anyway, I will have it by Thanksgiving, usually. So anyway, so I'll wait till after Thanksgiving. Then I'll do the home tour where, you know, I'm showing every little detail, showing trees up really, really close. I mean, I've shown some of them really close, but, and I'll put all the music and everything to it like I always do. So anyway, let's just have a quick look. So you saw my garland. You see Lacey over there going crazy with her dolphin. And those dog beds, I just lay them there. The dogs move them all over the place as they like them and they get comfortable. So that's just there for now. But there's my gold and silver tree. I mean, it's a gold tree, but I've got gold and silver bulbs and decorations all through there. And obviously a silver bow and a silver tree skirt. And those stockings are matching. And, of course, my wreath that I need to move over. And then there's this. Hold on. Where's the switch? So that's a little caroling thing. Unfortunately, that you can't put it on mute. It constantly will play those songs. If I could put it on mute where I could just see the things going, I'd have that running all the time. But the music, it gets annoying after a while. I only turn it on once in a while. So we always put those elves there. And over here on my dresser, I have some poinsettias, Father Christmas, and a snowman. And so that's it for there. And this piece usually sits on a little dresser thing that I have in the bathroom, I'll show you. And I usually have it over there by the Christmas tree, but that's what that sits on. And I just leave it there on the floor. So anyway, that is my room. And then here in the bathroom, it's just the typical, I have my Father Christmas there, a floral centerpiece thing there, some carolers and a little shelf bear, my Christmas tree. And this is really cozy. Oh, I got a snowman over there. This is really cozy, you know, in the evenings, and if I light my candles and that when it's completely dark outside, and then I have my tree. Sometimes I won't even have that light on. I'll just leave my tree and put candles. Then it's a very nice, cozy, you know, relaxing bath. And I have my snowman there. And this jewelry box, I usually have it right there. And this I have in my bedroom where the tree is. So, and this is, I'm thinking about getting rid of that, but I hate doing that because that costs a lot of money. But those colors don't go in my house anymore. But I usually keep that. My magazine rack is over there, and I usually have that next to the magazine rack. But anyway, so there's our little penguin. And I got Santa Claus right here. And then in the office, I have our Christmas tree. I always have that over there. It's on, but you can't see because of the skylight shining right on it. And I just stuck that Santa Claus over there. I have Frosty and Mrs. Frosty there. And I have some poinsettias in there. And that, I leave that out all year. Throughout my house in various rooms, I always leave one item of Christmas because I love Christmas. And so I leave one thing of Christmas just so that I can see it throughout the year, and just, it, you know, gives me still a lot of Christmas cheer throughout the year. And the last thing I have is this menorah that I have to plug in down over there. So I was telling you guys yesterday I was going to look for a spray or something to put here. And I usually leave the two candles here with the snowman and the penguin that's in my bathroom, and another garland that I had here, but it was old. And anyway, when I'm downstairs at night, it's real blinding. So I had to actually change from nightlight light bulbs to these because they're not so bright. And I reduced it to one candle. And this is that Christmas Around the World candle ring. And this is actually the whole candle that's down in my kitchen. I brought it up here and put it with this. And I put two nutcrackers here so you can see from down in the family room. And then from this way in the hallway, I put this little house and this little house. So that's what that looks like from this angle. And I'll show you what it looks like downstairs. That's what you see from down here. And just to update a little bit of what I've done in the last couple days in decorating down here. So I told you I had to bring my smokers out. And these are all German smokers from Germany. And I showed you I got my angels and, well, yeah, those and the candlesticks. And this is what I usually put here, this bear with this wreath and my candy dish, and I keep my candle there. And every year I put something different here. This year I decided to do these Christmas trees, and that one right here turns on and lights a couple different colors. And I showed you my wise man. And then today I told you I was going to clear off my table, which I did, and I've got all my Christmas things on here. So only thing that's different is usually I have this slid down a little bit more, and I have my candy canes and a little see that red candle thing that's on the TV there. It's kind of like that, but it's like this. It's glass and it's got, you know, some painting and stuff on there. But I decided not to bring that out this year. So instead what I did, I got this plate, oh, I want to say 2 years ago at the Christmas tree shop, where I've gone in there, like when I got all my fall decor, I went to a Christmas tree shop, I went to Michael's, but I bought this, I think it was about 2 years ago, and it looks like one of those old Victorian style plates. Well, it's like a replica of it. And so I just decided to take my extra candy canes that I had, and I'll put candy canes here. And then probably when I get like the holiday Hershey Kisses and stuff, I'll probably put them around there as well. So anyway, that is my table.